I'm just now realizing that I've been talking and nothing has been picking up. I'm just now realizing that. Crazy. So let's start from the very beginning. What's up, y'all? It's Mo back again with another video. Again, I gotta look over here. What's up, y'all? It's Mo back again with another video. And I hope you're having a wonderful day, a wonderful night whenever you're watching this. I appreciate you for coming and enjoying this game with me, enjoying this experience with me. We are back at it again with episode 5 on Alan Wake 2. So let's just go ahead and get straight into it, all right? Hopefully I have all the clips and I can show y'all the point to how we got here and everything like that, but let's get right into it. This is so not safe for him. Yeah, that's I was saying, like, for him to be in whatever. That's what I was saying, like, for him to be in whatever dark place that he is. Him just walking around unprotected is definitely, like, not safe for him at all.
I had written for years. Picking up Casey's gun felt like I was assuming the role of the detective. I had a light now. I needed to get back to the subway station entrance.
Shit.
With the alley in darkness now, less the shadows block my way.
Fuck! could use the light to open the subway entrance now.
So not safe for him.
I needed to find another light to go deeper inside. I need her to find a way around that fence.
Again, I believe this is all because of the fact that he has IDD. So, what if he's actually killing these people? Because it's not him in the light or in control. So what if, like, when he is, like, you know, fighting these people or fighting these people with the light or shooting these people, he's actually killing them? Like, what if that's the case? But I digress. I know I'm gonna die a couple times playing this game. The only thing for me is just how I end up dying and why. You're gonna make me walk all the way down here? Nah, I gotta be the other way. only reason why I'm running is because I'm trying to, like, get it over with. Because I'm low-key kind of freaked out. I ain't trying to be here long. I ain't trying to be over here long, bro. Why do you keep saying his name? Yeah, some shit about to go down. A difficult, tough moment is about to go down. Cause they put a whole. Battery pack. They just keep saying his name, keep whispering his name.
Resonated with meeting. Had I written this?
Restore 50%. Restore 50 health for each second. When using flash boost on hostage, provide 10% chance to stun enemies on flash boost, provides 25 chance to regain a flash charge on kill. I'm so confused on how this works. Words of action. Increase damage dealt to close proximity. Ink weight 20% harder to detect. Yes, absolutely. Oh, wait. But once I select something, I can't go back. Oh, wow. Alrighty. Oh, shoot. I died. I don't know how. I gotta utilize running and, you know, having him run and stuff.
Gates to the platform were closed. I had a ticket.
You had a ticket? What the hell does that mean?
The door wouldn't budge. Something about the station platform felt significant. It would work in my writing, but I needed more. Something lingered here. A half-forgotten memory. An echo. Something was here. A vision about to reveal itself. I needed to look at it from the right angle. Flash of inspiration. The ghost of my fictional detective.
What?
A story thread I could use in my writing. I had a location. I had a story thread. I would put them together, write them into my story to create a path deeper into the dark place. I was making progress. The dark place reacted to my story.
The way into the tunnels was no longer blocked. The Fed had glimpsed into the maw of darkness. It swallowed him whole. The tracks led into the tunnel. That was my way forward.
Okay. Just for clarification, all of this is still happening in the past, I guess. He's still explaining his past story to us because we found him and he was sitting there. So he's explaining to us like his end or his side of the story. But I don't see how this is necessarily relevant, especially with the fact that if this is happening 13 years ago, or he's explaining what's happening 13 years ago, I don't know. I don't see the point of in going through this. That's me personally, but I don't see the point of going through all this. Hopefully it explains later, but yeah, right now this is irrelevant to me. Keep saying like weird.
The blood trail continued deeper into darkness.
Right now, where is he going to? He escaped the studio. He got a call. They told him to go here, but he's just going here just because he was told to go here. I don't know. To me, it's ridiculous.
Tunnels were a maze. The blood trail led me on. Another place to use in this story. I needed to search the tunnels for further visions. Inspiration for the story that would lead me deeper. I had a new location for the story. I changed the story. And with that, the dark place changed.
Some fed came looking for the cult, but it was a trap. A satanic blood sacrifice.
Anyone who gets involved with the cult, they're next. I heard their leader is this famous writer, Alan Wake. Their unholy motherfucking
mistake. What?
Sounds like a load of bull.
So he's a cult leader.
Another echo lingered here, a source of inspiration.
What do you know? The word is, your research can help me, ma'am. What do you know?
There's more than one urban legend about the cult of the word. The murder cult used these tunnels for their ritual sacrifices. They say the cult reenacted the murders in Alan Wake's crime books. That Wake was even involved somehow, under a false identity. Mr. Scratch, which is, of course, a nickname for the devil himself.
It was disturbing finding myself in the story this way. But I was desperate.
I don't even know what to say. Like, I'm getting all this information, it's pieces, but I don't know what to say because I can't put all the pieces together yet. What it sounds like is that the other half, the other personality of Alan Wake that has the light or takes over the light is somehow, some way, some magical witch doctor, cult leader, or whatever. Him, the version that we see, is a story writer. What it seems like is that the story writer writes out these stories, writes out these books, and et cetera, et cetera. Then the cult leader takes over, makes those stories into real life, or what is happening is that the cult leader is doing these certain things, doing these certain actions, and the Alan Wake story writer is writing out what took place throughout his mind, throughout his memories, what he's learning throughout the walking through the dark place, seeing these echoes and learning. It's one of the two. That's what I'm piecing together so far. But other than that, I have no idea. And I don't understand how he's privy to conversations that are being had without him being there. But nonetheless.
And it felt right for the story. Water was gone. The way forward was open. was humming. Was it worth the risk to go see who?
I mean, you don't really got a choice, buddy. It doesn't seem like you really got much of a choice. He said something about a daughter. This is gonna pop.
The train blocked my way forward, but it was here for a reason. It had a role to play. I had a new idea, a new story thread.
So I can either go to the path of continuing with the murderous cult, or I can continue to get more information about the missing FBI agent. The cult used fire to claim dominion over the tunnel. And then it says for missing FBI, it says the agent had come here looking for the cult for trouble. It says continue down the college trail, so.
The scene had changed.
Should have went with the agent.
The cult poured the gasoline over the train car. An iron cage.
Wait, can I'm out?
Anyone there?
Dead.
Okay, so I can write back and forth, back and forth.
Thank you.
cultists track down the torchbearers living in the tunnels. The poor folks up in a derailed subway car, doused it in gasoline. Yeah.
Charming.
It turns into a bit of a ghost story after that.
Torchbearers.
The dark smoke from the fire still roams the tunnels searching for new victims to devour.
There are no happy endings in this city.
The story thread felt important. I could use it in one of the scenes I'd found. I had a new beat for the story.
Did it though.
The subway car had become a burnt husk. I could get through it now.
Oh wow.
Was blocked. I had to find a way through. The lights would help me.
haven't even seen him.
Echoing Hall had a story to tell.
Wake.
The new story beat fit the story perfectly. Changed into the murder cult's hideout. The cultists were close now, a dark presence rising from the depths.
Something here that made him run scared. Whether the summoning ritual had been a bona fide supernatural event or the mass psychosis of stark raving lunatics, it didn't change the facts. The cult was messing with things no one should mess with.
The ritual was a vital part of the story, the key to reaching the murder site. This new plot beat would carry me deeper into the story.
Your friends will meet him when you're gone.
missing something? I'm so confused, bro. Oh my God. What the heck do you want me to do, bro?
The plot element I found would drive the story forward. Wake.
Shit!
It's frustrating because of the fact that all I got is a damn flashlight. Oh Lord, I'm gonna start all over. I just want to get past this part, bro.
You
heartbeat would carry me deeper into the story.
confused. I don't know if this is supposed for me to go back upstairs. Like, what? I'm lost, bro.
A new idea, a new story thread.
Am I really supposed to be leaving? I'm so confused right now, bro. I'm so confused. There's a question mark circle there. There's a in the main thing. I'm mad confused. confused, like, where I'm supposed to go right now. Let me see. Complete the ritual. What is the ritual? Bro, now I gotta go back over there. Oh my goodness. It says summon the, finish the ritual, but how do I do that? A collapsed tunnel. Complete the ritual in the collapsed tunnel. Collapsed tunnel is over here. I guess this is collapsed tunnel. So I have to go back to the collapsed tunnel. Where's the murder site? Because it said reach the murder site. Where's the murder site? There's a question here. Let me go to that question spot. I don't know where the murder site is at, so I don't know, bro. This murder site is supposed to be at. I don't know where this murder site is supposed to be at, bro. but as far as like, okay, so we're getting somewhere.
I couldn't hear the dark presence. It was gone.
Into the unblocked tunnel.
The tunnel was open now. I could get through.
How am I supposed to fight something I absolutely can't see?
I couldn't hear the dark presence. It was gone. The tunnel was open now. I could get through. The dark presence. Seen it before. I remembered now. It was always out there, hunting me.
What is he talking about? Oh my goodness, what is this, bro? This is the forest. This is a nightingale. This is his body that we're walking up to.
I found the murder site. Somehow the victim's heart was the key. Something had shifted. I felt an overwhelming closeness to home. An FBI agent?
Okay, so we're back to where we met up.
This is Alan Wake. I'm trapped here. The dark place. Under Cauldron Lake.
Not Cauldron Lake. Where are you?
I'm trying to escape. I'm making progress, but I'm in danger. The dark presence. Help me. Please, help me. I could sense it. I was closer to home. Had the woman in the vision helped me somehow? Something had changed outside Parliament Tower, where I'd lived with Alice. It was out there.
What? Alice.
Waiting for me.
Alice. Jesus Christ. Like always, they give some good music at the end of each chapter or part. But hey man, here we are again. And it is. Oh, I can't read it. 11:21 PM. I don't know if I'm gonna continue. Cause this, even just this from start to finish, took 2 hours. Maybe mostly because I was dying and I didn't know where I was going or what I was doing. I'm going to start checking the goals from now on, making sure I click the goals to check the goals. But yeah, man, hey, I appreciate you. Yep, you. For coming and watching and joining with me, sitting here while I go through this whole progress, a full, raw, uncut process of this game. No edits. I'm not editing anything. It's a full, uncut, raw walkthrough of this game. So I appreciate you for sticking around with me, probably getting frustrated, screaming at me, telling me what to do. But I mean, I can't hear you. So thank you again for going through this process with me. If you liked the video or if you enjoyed the video, make sure you leave a like, make sure you comment, make sure you subscribe, make sure you hit that notification bell, make sure you share it to somebody that you feel will also like this type of content or will like this video specifically. But hey man, like always, I love you and I will see you in the next video. Peace.